They have asked me and asked you to treat this exercise with the utmost respect. Every graduate deserves to hear his or her name announced at this special time. Please refrain from using any noise makers, loud horns, bells, loud yells, or any other distraction that would not be conducive to maintaining the dignity and grandeur of this event. We ask that you hold your applause and congratulatory yells after all names have been called so that the next name can be heard as they come across the stage. Your assistance with this and help with this to provide the very best graduation for each student is appreciated. Thank you in advance for your cooperation. If for some reason you have a young child that needs to get unruly, please take the child to the foyer so they can settle that down and then return to your seat. These graduates have earned the right to have the very best commencement ever. So welcome you once again. Allow me to introduce my platform. I will begin to my left. To my left, I have Brandon L. Jones, the senior class president. Next to him is our senior class vice president. Next to him is the senior class president, Ms. Johnny Valdez. Next to her is executive director for the Kimball Cluster, Ms. Kristen Brown. Sitting next to her is our board trustee from District 6, Ms. Carl Ranger. Next to her is our Dr. Shalonda Pruitt, our associate principal. Sitting next to her, Mauricio Dominguez, assistant superintendent for Division 1. Sitting next to him is Ms. Rebecca Rodriguez, chief communication officer for Dallas Independent School District. Sitting next to her is our salutatorian, Stephanie Almendares. And sitting next to her is our valedictorian for this year, Fernando Sagata. Please welcome them. This time we have a program, we will follow the program as printed. I stepped up just a little bit. I take that liberty as being principal of this high school to bring you welcome first. And now I'm going to call to the platform Ms. Valdez. She will bring you a location, and then we will follow from there. Thank you, Ms. Valdez.
Good morning to all. I am Mariana Valdez, president of Justin Ford Kimball High School Senior Class of 2013. Today, we are gathered to celebrate the achievements and completion of the 2012-2013 school year. For many students, there were obstacles to overcome and time was limited, but eventually, the challenging year was fulfilled. Our success is not a single step, it is a journey. We are going to be expected to fail, but it will be our job to get right back up. We have all made it this far to realize that we can do so much better in the future. Most of us have not really spoken college and these are names and know the skills that are hard to share.
introduce to now, a young man that has been the number one student in the class of 2013 this year and last year. He has made a mark just in the high school. Please help me welcome to the podium valedictorian this year, Fernando Gallo.
The freshman teachers for tolerating the then goofball moron losers of the class of 2013. We were narrow-minded our freshman year, and we were not even considering graduation. Sophomore year came, and we entered this year the same way we entered our freshman year. However, this year we had expectations, and we were challenged to change the school's academic approval rating. What a task it truly was. We thought of it as child's play. I thought of it as a child's play, and the urgency of the situation was mitigated by our attitudes and inability to come together and discover our potential. We had taken on the task with the mindset that we cannot do everything. And guess what? We failed with some of the lowest scores in Kimball's history. We failed our school, we failed our sophomore teachers, we failed our friends, but most importantly, we failed ourselves. Believe me when I say, this changed everyone's mindset in the class and affirmed the negative views for those who did not believe us. But those who held negative views did not know that we will not refuse to do something that we can do. We entered the junior year with a broadened perspective, a mindset to take on this challenge of passing the state exam, and a desire to learn from our mistakes. We now had a common purpose, a common dream, which some even doubted was achievable, but we took on the task. We were finally exploring ourselves, our weaknesses, our strengths. We lost our immaturity because of our realization that this was it. We finally began to realize our abilities, our limits, and surpass what was previously unsurpassable. We finally started to grow as a class into what will become us today. When the time came and the state exams were administered, we were ready. And guess what? We passed with some of the best scores Kimball has ever seen. For once, we were all happy and shared something in common, success. This truly made everyone in the class of 2013 and all the teachers who helped us into something special, a Kimball family. And here we are, senior year. What a year has been. This was the era of good feeling for our class. We all had pride in us, in the school, and in the unity that many teachers like Ms. McGee saw for us. We were able to enjoy the perks of high school, such as going to prom, developing senioritis, finding someone special and starting a relationship, skipping class during senior skip day, but most importantly, graduation. We are all here, hearing not only a brief history of our high school career, but an example that even though there may be bumps on the road, a wrong turn or a breakdown, we are able to do what it takes to persevere through any obstacle that comes our way, because we will not refuse to something we can do. We have the talent, the abilities, and are in full realization of this fact as we are about to venture forth into the world as graduates. So I say, challenge accepted to what lies ahead. We would like to thank Ms. Nishikawa, Ms. McMullen, Mrs. Johnson, Ms. McGee, Mr. Diaz, Mr. Singleton, and the countless other teachers who have impacted our lives, as well as all the graduates for putting up with each other and making us a family. But most importantly, we thank our families who have dealt with us since our beginning. We cannot do everything, but all of you have made it possible for us to do something. Now, as we are about to part ways, and some for the last time, I would like to leave the class of 2013 with a saying that not only will unite us, but remind us of the struggles and adversity we have overcome together. This was inspired by Ms. McMullen, and it is this. Repeat after me, graduates, if you will. I am capable of accomplishing any goal I set for myself. I am determined to prove all my oppressors wrong. I am prepared for any challenge that is presented. I am officially a graduate from the class of 2013. Congratulations and thank you.
Carlo Angel was elected to the Dallas Independent School Board of Trustees in June 2006. She graduated magna cum laude from the University of Memphis with a Bachelor of Arts and received a Master of Arts from the University of Illinois. Mrs. Ranger is a tireless advocate for education and the importance of reading and a strong believer in personal and professional development and service. Her work with youth and community has brought her national honors as a trailblazer for special community projects. She focuses on student success and has helped many students receive scholarships in academic creative arts. Would you please help me welcome our Board of Trustees member, Mrs. Carla Ranger.
Thank you very much, and congratulations to you and to all of our seniors. Good morning, everyone. I am honored to be one of the first to congratulate you, 2013 seniors, on a job well done and on taking the next step to what can be an exciting future. And yes, that deserves an applause. To see you graduate is one of the proudest moments for me as a trustee, as it is for your parents, your loved ones, and friends who have seen you grow and blossom into the seniors you are today. So on behalf of the Dallas ISD Board of Trustees, I want to thank all of you for persevering. Remember, there were some who started out with you in the ninth grade who are not here. We are so glad that you are persistent, and that you are now graduating on this wonderful day. We also want to thank all of you parents, families, and friends for your support, your love, your sacrifices, all that you gave to help our students be where they are today. Students, let's take a moment to thank our parents, our loved ones, and our friends for all they did for you. On the count of three, give them your best applause. One, two, three. Now, Fernando mentioned all of the teachers and gave us a wonderful chronology of what happened to you from the ninth grade to your success today. And these teachers are here surrounding you and the staff members, and they have given you great care and love for the last 4 years through some valleys, and then they helped you to go up the mountains and climb all the way to the top. And I know that while individually you have thanked them, and you will continue to during after this celebration, but let's collectively, and parents, you may join them, let's collectively thank the teachers, the staff, our principal and administration for all they've done to help you wear your caps and gowns today. On the count of three, we're going to say thank you. One, two, three. Thank you. I know that you have received and will be receiving many cards and notes giving you advice and telling you what to do and offering little tips to you. So I'm not going to add to those today. I just want to take a few minutes to place in the middle of this celebration a song I thought about that was written back in 1920, as a matter of fact, a children's folk song. And it became even more popular during the 60s and the 70s, during the height of the civil rights movement. But that song, this song, has a profound message, I believe, and it's a very personal message for each of you. The song is entitled, "This Little Light of Mine." Now, Fernando reminded you in his speech that you're only one person, but there's a lot you can do as that one person. That song, "This Little Light of Mine," reminds you that we were all placed here on earth to be a light. You have the light in you. Now, it depends on where you let your light shine and how brightly you let it shine. The song says, "This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine." And then a third time, "This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine." And the second verse says, "Everywhere I go, I'm going to let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm going to let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm going to let it shine. My light. I'm going to let it shine, let it shine, let it shine." I want you to keep that in mind. Whatever you do, if you're going on to college, if you're going to the military, if you're going on to work, whatever you're doing, remember that you have that, you possess, each one of you. You are a light. So how are you going to let your light shine? And exactly what does it mean to let your light shine? Well, you let your light shine when you do good work and you do good deeds for others to see. You let your light shine when you're honest and responsible. You let your light shine when you give love and joy, when you show that you care about good people and good causes. You let your light shine when you give service to your community. You let your light shine when it seems as if there's no place else you can go, you can't go any further, you don't have the money for college, you can't pass this course. You let your light shine, and you will see your way, and there will be others who will see your light, and they will help to guide you through. You let your light shine when you think for yourself and you do the right thing. You let your light shine when you read so that you will know and you will develop insight and wisdom and understanding and make good choices. You let your light shine when you look forward. Don't look back. When you look up and hold your head up, not down. When you look outward and not always selfishly inside. You let your light shine, graduates, when you set a positive goal and when you do something, you perform some act or some action every day to reach that goal. Now, letting your light shine will radiate. Others will see it, and you never know, you may be some encouragement. Your light may be some encouragement to them. Because letting your light shine attracts good things. Letting your light shine attracts good people. Remember, remember, whatever you do, you were placed here, like all of us, to be a light. So now, graduates, as you make the decision as to how you will let your light shine, I want to do something that I do every year with every graduating class, give some affirmation, and I want you to remember these words and every day think about, how am I going to let my light shine? So I'm going to ask you in a few minutes after I repeat this verse for you to stand and say it as well. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm going to let it shine. Let it shine all the time. Let it shine. You got it? You're smart. You passed all those tests. You raised your score. Stand up and let's see if we can't say that. And our parents and friends and family, I want you to listen to them. And as they say it, I want you to see how brightly, how much brighter this room will be. All right? Now, I'm going to say it for you once more. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm going to let it shine all the time, let it shine. Ready? On the count of three, all right? One, two, three. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Now, next time you say it, let it shine a little bit brighter. Let the person up at the top hear you. All right, once more. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Now, everywhere I go, I'm going to let it shine. Let it shine all the time. Let it shine. Everybody, let's give them a hand and tell them how bright this room feels. Now, you may be seated. You may be seated. Now, with your applause, audience, in just a second, I want you to say these words and applaud these seniors, because already this room is brighter and I believe they're going to let their light shine. And I want you to tell them on the count of three and then give them great applause. Shine on, bright lights. Shine on. And you can remember your part. All right, everybody, on the count of three. One, two, and you look right at your loved one, right at your senior, and spread that light to all of them when you say, shine on, bright lights, shine on. All right, everybody ready? One, two, three. Shine on, bright lights, shine on. Congratulations.
Thank you, Trustee Ranger, for those words. And this class, I know, will have shining lights. It's a very special class, and I know they will shine everywhere they go. So thank you for those words. Let me take just a quick second and have all of the faculty and staff members from Justin F. Kimball to please stand and be recognized. They've done an excellent job this year, as every year. Please stand, faculty and staff, and be recognized. Justin F. Kimball, faculty and staff. You look marvelous as well, faculty and staff. Thank you for being here, and of course, thank you for all of your support. I want to thank my wife. One of my daughters is here this afternoon, or this morning. Thank you for being here, because believe you me, she has to put up with a lot during the school year. So thank you for being here as well and supporting this occasion. At this time, I'd like to have Ms. Rodriguez and Board Trustee Ranger to step up and join me here at the podium. It is at this time that I'm preparing to certify these graduates. And we move into this part of our program where I know you've been sitting very patiently waiting for this part of the program. As principal, of Justin Ford Kimball High School, I hereby affirm that each candidate has met all requirements for graduation as determined by the State of Texas and the Dallas Independent School District, and they are qualified to receive their diplomas, or they are otherwise qualified to participate in this graduation ceremony consistent with the laws of the State of Texas and the Dallas Independent School District. Ms. Rodriguez.
Thank you. As a cabinet member, Rebecca Rodriguez, Chief of Communications of the Dallas Independent School District, I'm pleased to confirm the certification of the 2013 graduating class of Kimball High School. Congratulations.
Principal Earl Jones, I am pleased to award the diplomas certifying that these seniors are graduates of the Dallas Independent School District.
Thank you. We are now ready to step into that arena to issue diplomas. Let me just remind you, audience, I know you've been patient and I know you want to cheer for your student, and I want you to, but just keep in mind that another name will be called right after your son or daughter's name. And let's respect that and bring our applause down so every name can be heard. They have earned the right to hear their name as they come across this stage. So let's prepare to present diplomas.
Kiana Daughtry. Maria Hernandez. Jamisha Renee Lewis. Teresita Armenta. Karina Ortiz. Marianne Guidry. Adrian Drake. Selena Diaz. Kendra Jones. Lamana Ashton. Christian Davalos. Victor R. Johnson. Dahlia Portillo. David Fuentes Reyes. Ty Iman Harvey. Jordan Adams. Brynisha Brown. Esmeralda Garcia. Victor Howe. Byron Dabbs. Diamond McDaniel. Nancy Mendoza. Diana Rodriguez. Ashley Neros. Chelsea Taylor. Christian Vigil. Alfonso Garcia. Alberto Escalante. Maria Medina. Juan Alanis. Jessica Alcantar. Ashley Allen. David Alvarez. Amy Angeles. Zavicia Anthony. Yesel Avila. Jamarly Bailey. Danielle Banks. Vershundria Barnes. Adriana Bartolo. Jonathan Blaylock Briscoe. Leila Bocanegra. Magali Bonilla. Deandra Broomfield. Theocious Broussard. Xavier Brown. Andre Burks. Brianna Burks. Edward Butler. Roshandria Caldwell. Carolina Camargo. Christian Cano. Eduardo Cantu. Kavicia Carter. Ramiro Castillo Jr. Miguel Chagoya. Emmanuel Charles. Kiona Cole. Deanna Collis Waddell. Cesar Coronado. Lakedra Crockett. Karen Cuadros. Christopher Dabney. Edgar Davila. Ariel Davis. Jordan Davis. Mayela Delgado. Jesse Dominguez. Jacoby Donnell. Brandon Douglas. Destiny Drake. Christopher Duncan. Deaston Dyson. Reagan Easter. Diana Elizalde. Macy Enriquez. Monica Escalante. Selena Estrada. Adam Fendel. Yadira Flores Rodriguez. Keith Frazier. Kamaya Fuller. Ephraim Garcia. Linda Garcia. Terrion Gibson. Abriana Glenn. Karan Glover. Veronica Gomez. Adrian Gonzalez. Edgar Gonzalez. Fabian Gonzalez. Deshadrick Goss. Aaron Green. Nisha Green. Jesus Guerrero. Abel Gutierrez. David Hammond. Chastity Hampton. Eric Harris. Crystal Hernandez. Jonathan Hernandez. Lucero Hernandez. Patricia Hernandez. Alexis Hill. Brandon Hines. Shanice Holloway. Justice Leanne Holmes. Jerrica Hubbard. Luis Hurtado Rebollar. Aaron Jackson. Nigel Jackson. Latavia James. Deontay Jenkins Dawson. LaShashiel Johnson. Kevin Josue Jolly. Yasmin Juarez. Charlie Key the Third. Cammy Lewis. Gabriel Lilly. Laron Livingston. Yvette Lopez. Marco Lopez. Ashley Malone. Karina Mancia. Justin Manning. Adela Marquez. Edwin Martinez. Elvia Martinez. Eunice Martinez. Janet Martinez. Mariana Molina. Maria Mondragon. Maria Monjaras. Martha Montañez. Pablo Rodrigo Montoya. Nancy Moreno. Jose Moreno Torres. Printavius Moorhead. Ashley Moses. Demarcus Mosley. Candace Murchison. Elena Najera. Maricela Najera. Marisol Najera. Juan Navarro. Lorenzo Nino. Jerica Latoy Knowles. Vilma Ochoa. Adrián Olivares. Karina Ovedo. Chardell Page. Guadalupe Parada. St. Clair Parker. Tierica Payne. Noe Peña. Sergio Perez. Stefan Fenisi. Tyrone Pinson. Maria Fernanda Ponce. Yanira Prado. Dimitri Proctor. Esmeralda Ramirez. Esperanza Ramirez. Alonso Reina. Lorenzo Rivera. Leandre Roberts. Delfino Rodriguez. Jose Rodriguez. Luis A. Rojas. Luis I. Rojas. Griselda Salas. Adán Salazar. Araceli Salazar. Ricky Salgado. Rudy Sanchez. Mariela Servin Perez. J. Roderick Smith. Jesus Soto. Omar Soto. Devante Stevens. Drew Kelly Stevens. Taylor Stewart. Julio Tafoya. Travion Thibodeau. Tyler Kedrian Thomas. Abril Torres. Jonathan Torres. Miriam Torres. Brianna Trimble. DeMarcus Turner. Journey Turner. Jeremy Valdez. Adiel Vargas. Jasmine Vasquez. Carla Vasquez. Carlos Velasquez. Andrea Velasquez. Monica Veliz. Eric Vera. Edward Victorian. Margarita Villegas. Daryl Walker. Isaiah Walker. Vanessa Wells. Kayla Willis. Marquise Willis. Edith Zuniga.
All right. Graduates, would you please stand? Graduates, move your tassels as official graduates. Move your tassels. Address your crowd. Address your crowd. Graduates, address your crowd. Wave to your crowd. At this time, we will prepare graduates to sing our alma mater, led by our platform president and vice president. All right, guests, would you please remain seated during the recessional as we prepare for our recessional.